Hey, so here's been working on this virtual pinball machine, and I finally was able to get most of it done, so I figured I would create a live video, and you can kind of see what I got so far. This is originally was a Arcade1up machine. I got it. After I got it, I gutted it out, added a PC, added new software, new hardware, everything, and this is where I'm at now. So as you can see, I have a LCD screen for my back glass, and then I have another digital board for my DMD and a 24-inch play field. The software running right now is Pinball Popper, and as you see, it's got a little bit of a screensaver, so as it's just sitting here rotating, it'll randomly pull up tables that I have installed. So here, I'll show you what I got. Let me start from the beginning. So as soon as you install Pinball Popper, it's going to load this game, which is called Leprechaun King. I find it to be kind of annoying. And then you're also going to get Retro Flare. It's an okay game. This game runs off of Future Pinball. I do have quite a few games of FX3. I have American Dad. Archer Pinball, Bob's Burgers, Doom, Earth Defense, El Dorado, Epic Quest, Excalibur, Fallout, Family Guy. This is a different version on FX Pinball versus the actual pinball table. You'll see in a second. Fishtails. Mars. Paranormal. Portal. Safecracker. Shaman. This game's actually called Citadel. What is the actual file name? It's called Citadel. This is Sorcerer's Lair. Quite a few Star Wars games. I don't have all the tables set up, but you'll see. For example, here's like Darth Vader. It's just have to go in and actually set it up. Multiple Star Wars cabinets. There's a champion pug. There's a few old tables. Skyrim. This is actually one of the better games, I think. Theater of Magic. This is the FX table version. I find it to run a little slow. I guess it could just be the capabilities of my PC. And B12. Alright, let's go back. Visual Pinball. Here we go. Alien Trilogy. Attack from Mars. Austin Powers. Avatar, Back to the Future, Def Leppard. This is actually a pretty interesting game. It's got good music. Diablo. Here's the other version of Family Guy, as I was referencing earlier. Iron Man. Zelda. Leprechaun King. This is an annoying game. Metallica. Sometimes you can just turn on the table just to listen to the music. Monopoly. Mustang. Nine Inch Nails. Predator. This game's actually really, really awesome. Roller Coaster Tycoon. Shrek. Hey, Ma. South Park. Stranger Things. Super Mario Brothers. Ninja Turtles. Terminator, Terminator 2, Terminator 3, Goonies. This one's a little quiet. Lord of the Rings, Jurassic Park, The Simpsons, The Walking Dead. This is Theater Magic. This is a better version. The Last Starfighter. This game's actually really awesome too. Transformers. Tron, The Legacy. This is probably the best game I've ever played. Plus, I love the movie. And X-Men. So that's all the tables I have installed. So I have everything controlled by actual buttons on my pinball machine. So here, I'll show you. So I got flipper and dudge on this side. Same on this side. And this is my start button, back button or exit, and there's a coin button. And this is actually an actual analog plunger. So it actually all works. Here, I'll play something here real quick. Let's go to... we'll play Goonies. So you just press the start button, it actually goes into the menu, and then you can select how you want to play it. One player, two players.
Please nice. Wait. I am now loading up the game.
Here, now it's loading up. Sort of coin. Here it is. Oh, I lost my ball already. Luckily it's saved. I'm not too good at this one. This one, so I just press the exit button, it'll go back to pinball popper. Actually, there you go, there's a that's how I run everything. Let me get rid of that little menu there. All right, let's go back to like Super Mario Brothers. Here we go.
Please wait, I am now loading up the game. Have fun.
It doesn't take too long to load. It's like 10, maybe 15 seconds or so. All right. There you go, just press start. Good to go. I don't know if you can see it, but here I'm going to use the nudge. And you see the back screen's going to warn me. Oh, there, I'll see tilt warning. And I lost my ball. basketball ball. There you go. So that's how that goes. Here then, since I'm done, I'll exit back again. I prefer the Zelda game is actually really fun too.
Please wait. I am now loading up the game. Have fun.
Some of the tables you'll find were actually never released until like an arcade. People that developed them on the PC, so sometimes you'll see games that you've never heard of. We're gonna press start. Here we go. Oh, damn it. So luckily my ball was saved again. So the objective in this one, there was five guys popping up here randomly. You gotta take them all out and then take out Ganon, which will open the castle, which eventually you'll get the four, or the three triangles, the Triforce in the middle. I've only gotten two so far. That's it. So, just thought I'd show you guys. I think it's pretty cool. It's probably the coolest thing I've ever built. Maybe I'll build something else next. But I still have to activate the solenoids. Hey, Bill. I was just showing pinball cabinet that I got done building. This thing's awesome. I love this thing. You can play like Family Guy. Actually, the South Park's pretty fun. Hey, yeah. Or Def Leppard, that's fun again.
Please wait. I am now loading up the game. Have fun.
Actually, I have a lot of Star Wars pinball machines on here. I'll play this one, and then I'll show you all the Star Wars tables that I have. That's what I'm saying. Ray should get like a Star Wars arcade and put it next to all of his collection. Good at this one either. All right, I'll get out of this. All right, I'm gonna go back. So here's Boba Fett. I just have to put all the stuff in to get the backdrop. Actually, I can show you how to do that. It's really not hard. So I created a button so I can get out of here. So here's system exit. Get out of there. I have to go to pinup popper configuration and then media manager, and then I have to go down to FX3, and it's gonna be down here. Let's see. So here's the play field, and then I just gotta find it. So it'll pull up a preview. There's the table, and then I download it. Takes just a little bit. This might be a little bit longer because if you look, you can't see the file name, but it's actually was recorded in 4K. Versus which HD, which is 1080p versus 4000, so a little more detail. Hey, Steph. Hey, Chris, how you doing? All right. I'll download just a few of them. I'm not gonna do them all because it does take a little bit of time. So if you do this, you do need a wireless keyboard, I prefer. So like, this has a little keypad on the side for mouse. It just makes it easier. Yeah, a lot of times I'll be doing this and I'll have to do something, and luckily I have a keyboard just nearby. So I just have like a little dongle or whatever you plug into a USB port. Alright, this one's almost done. It's very slow because it's so detailed. I don't know if you can see the little bar going across here. Could also be the internet connection is kind of slow. Yes. When you're retired, you get to do what you want now. Here, episode 4. Let's see if I can find us the less version of it. I don't want a flyby. I want the actual table. No, we could try the flyby. The flyby stuff is kind of cool too. All right. Plus, it'll go faster. I'm hoping. Yeah, that's a lot faster. I'm just gonna finish downloading this, and then I'll load it back up. You can see the two that I just added. Yeah, so the whole setup, I think, probably cost probably around $1,000 for everything. I got the machine for $500. Once I got it, I gutted it out, bought a new monitor. That was like $100. PC I got off Facebook. It's a fourth generation i7. So that was like $150. And then I added a video card. It was nothing great, just a GT710 video card with 2 gigabytes of RAM. It's not amazing, but it's better than nothing. And then just some miscellaneous hardware. All right, that's all done. All right, close this out. And then go back to exit and launch. Cool, all right, here we go. So here's the tables I was just playing with. So here's the Darth Vader one I just downloaded. As you can kind of tell, it's having a little trouble because it was so detailed. And then this one wasn't 4K. This was just HD versus 4K. And this one, actually, you can see, is a lot smoother. Yeah, I didn't make the whole thing. I bought the table, assembled, and then I gut it all out, and I did all the electronics and stuff, all the wiring. But building the cabinet, I think, would be pretty easy. It's just wood and screws, right? So, but I did all the wiring, all the buttons, everything. I prefer the pinball, virtual pinball or visual pinball, I think is a lot better than the FX tables. I play like Metallica. This one's pretty cool. This is actually a table made by Stern, so. If I would have used a better PC with a better processor, I think it would run a lot smoother, but try to do it on a budget. I mean, I don't want to break the bank. You can spend easily, you know, $800-$900 on a better PC. But then again, that goes total games. I can go back real quick. Here. Oops. So I have 36 games on this pinball table, or the emulator, and then I have another, let's see what it says, 32 games. Good morning, USA. So almost 70. Yeah, that's not bad. All the games are free. You just have to join like some forums or whatever on the internet. And then you just gotta go find everything and learn how to install it. Everything's kind of the same, but a lot of things are kind of different. So for example, here, like, what you know that I have? I'm not sure.
Come on down South Park and meet some friends of mine.
I think this South Park might have uninstalled it. They're called pup packs, pop-up videos, so as you're playing, movies or whatever will play in the background here. I find it to be a little bit distracting, to be honest. So, yeah, I deleted it. It takes up a lot of room. You know, you're trying to play pinball, and it's distracting enough just whatever on the little DMD screen. You know, let alone what's on the actual table. So when you're trying to, like, oh, that's cool. Then you get caught watching the screen instead of the ball.
Hello there, children.
Hey, kick the baby.
Don't kick the baby.
But let's see if this will work.
Please wait. I am now loading.
So this is a 9-inch nails table. This one, actually, you can see it's got the actual videos playing in the background.
No ticket, no entry.
see. And you can see in the back, the music video is playing. So this one's a little bit better than the Def Leppard table, because the Def Leppard table, when you lose your ball, the music stops and it starts all over. This one, every time, it just plays like a new video every time, so. Here, I'll just lose my ball. See, now it's gonna go back to playing Head Like a Hole. Alright. So like I said, it's kind of distracting. And just exit back out of there. I don't know why I did that. This actually is a really cool game. This one actually plays the videos as well, the pup pack. The last Starfire.
Please wait. I am now loading up the game. Have fun.
Almost zero lag. There's almost zero lag. I mean, it's a fraction of a second, so it's pretty instant. So here, I'm going to actually, so there's actually a little bit of lag. I wonder if it's probably still because of there's so much stuff going on. But I think if I exit completely, I could actually go to Pin a Popper. And instead of playing it that way, I could actually go to the actual game this way. Let's see if it works better this way. Yeah, see? It's a little smoother now. Yeah, take it easy, Chris. Phone's about to die anyway, so. Alrighty. Cool. Thanks for watching, Bill and Steph. I'll see you guys later. Have a good night.